Hi everyone, my name is Jessica and this is going to be my first tutorial. So please let me know what you think. So first, you want to start off with some gold. Alright, so here I'm just making the second part of the curves that go around the base, except for this one I'm only smoothing down the top part as it looks kind of cool with the bottom untouched. Alright, here we're gonna make the bottom of the axe, so the axe blades, and I'm just measuring proportion wise to see if it's around the right size, and you're going to want to cut it into a V, except the bottom should be flat, and then do that with the other one as well. Now I'm just flattening out the actual blade part. So you're going to want to cut one edge flat and then just keep going, like follow the lines of the V. Get the curve of the blade, you're just going to trim around in a circular motion, and after you've done that you're going to fix up the edges, and to get it more like blade like take your medium ball tool, go along the edges, especially the edge of the blade, as it will make it look sharper. To attach them, you just want to stick them on and smooth them over. I also added a little point at the end of it, because that's what the picture has, and you just want to make it into a triangle-ish shape. Here, I'm just making a little rectangle to put in between the axe blades. Then you smooth it down and poke three holes in it, and it's just decoration that was on the blade. Now, I know you can't see this part too well, it's kind of bad planning on my part, but you're going to want to make a circle, then a small circle, then a really small circle on top, and that just adds to the height of the key. And then you take a small snake and put it in between the big and the medium circles. You can also put your head pin in now if you want to have a head pin. So on the gold part of the blades, there are little question mark swirly type things. So here, that's just what I'm making, except I accidentally made them point inwards when they're supposed to point outwards. However, I think it still looks okay, so just if you guys are making it, just remember that the question marks go the other way. So now that the base is done, it's time to pull out your translucent clay. And I am just sketching on the clay and tracing out a kind of, it's kind of like the raindrop shape, so that you can just put it on over top. Next, I'm just making a really thin little golden snake that goes around the translucent clay. And it just cleans things up and makes it look really pretty. And then there's also a little dot in it. As you can see here, I'm just tracing out the Taurus symbol. And next you can either paint it or use clay. I did use clay because I think it looks better. It gives more 3D illusion. And one of the last pieces is you need to make a little bull head. And at first I thought this was a snake head, so it kind of looks snaky, and then I realized that this was a bull key, and that wouldn't make any sense. So you just want to take three pieces, three little rectangles, and square them together, and make sure they're nice and smooth. And you just put them right over the side, or underneath the bottom of the translucent. So for the finishing touches, you're just going to make two little eyes for the bull, as well as two little nostrils. And to finish off, if you haven't already, just fill in the Taurus symbol. Alright, and this is what it looks like when it's done. You baked it according to the instructions on your clay, and I'm really happy with how this turned out. It is a bit shorter than the other one that I made, because I made the Libra one here, and I really love how this one turned out, but for the tutorial I wanted to make one that was a bit simpler, so I chose the Taurus one. If you liked it, please let me know. Let me know what you guys thought about my first tutorial. Was it good? Was it bad? Was there anything that I could improve on? And leave me some suggestions for things you guys want to see in the future.